Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I want to share with you all the rest of my polish rack for summer of 2022. So this is the Summer Nail Polish Rack 2022 collaboration video continuation for me. If you want to check out the first video, it is a shorter video. It's about 13 minutes long, and I basically narrow down the color and finish of polishes that are on my summer rack, but I was asked to showcase all of the polishes that I have on my summer rack, and that's what we're going to do. I'm gonna show you all of them. As per usual, this kind of video is a rather longer video. I don't talk much in it. I just showcase the polishes and keep on going. If you've seen my previous videos for my summer racks, you know how it is. And please don't forget to check out all of the participations for this collaboration. They're going to be listed down below, as well as the playlist that I have for summer polish rack 2022. Before we get started, I want to talk about the polish that I'm currently wearing on my nails right now, and this is Dior Splash. Dior Splash is a polish that I received as a gift from my husband when we were vacationing in Florida one year. I can't remember what year it was. It's about 3-4 years ago at this point, and I try to wear it every summer. This is a very well-loved polish. You can kind of see how much I've already worn it. I'm actually wearing this on my toes right now, and I wore it while I was on vacation, but then I went swimming, and it, like, got messed up, so I just took off my nail polish. Anyways, I decided, since I have already worn this by itself, I decided to add a topper. The topper that I'm currently wearing right now is this Glam polish that I received for PR, and this is Rainbows and Unicorns, and this polish is a beautiful, fun topper. I love it. My husband does not like it. He says there's too much going on, there's too many colors, but he does think the combination looks cute. He's just like, it's a lot happening there. And I'm like, yeah, I like it though. It's fun. We're gonna start off with the top tier of my 5-layer tiered rack, and it's Mainstream. This is a Zoya topper, and it's Soho Punch. I've had this for many years, and I have yet to wear it. I don't think this is gonna look as good as I'm picturing it in my head as a topper, but we're gonna try it out. Next, we have Zoya in Scout. This is for my ugly pretty Fridays that I try to get into but never do. This is Zoya Dara, and this is a pixie dust. Zoya in Walker. H&M in Sky High. And in case you thought it was similar to Walker, this is Sky High and Walker, and they are not as similar as you may have thought. H&M in Kiwi. I have Color Club in Get Lost. This was gifted to me. China Glaze in Casual Friday. China Glaze in She's So Extraterrestrial. Essie in Mint Candy Apple. And this is the blue one. This is Essie in The Cabana. Looks very similar to Splash in the bottle, but actually they're not. Splash is definitely more blue. This one leans a little bit more green. They're in the same color family, obviously. This is Essie in Fiji. Essie in Lilacism. Essie in I'll See You Later. This is from the new summer collection. Essie in Bikini Sotini. Some of these have transferred over from the spring rack. Morgan Taylor in Into the Limelight. Morgan Taylor in She's a Classic from the Clueless collection. Orly in So Fly. Orly in Neon Paradise. Orly in Put the Top Down. At this point, I don't know if this is the correct color for this polish, since I've had it for 2 years now. I've had neons from Orly fade on me, so I don't know if this is the correct color. I see a lot of ugly bottle syndrome happening here, but I still like the way that it looks. Orly in Afterglow. Orly in for the first time. Formula X polishes, which are discontinued, and this one is in Discovery. LA Color Pop Craze, or Color Craze, and this one is in Aloha. We have OPI, My Chihuahua Doesn't Bite Anymore. It's coming across a lot more corally in this video, I think, but I feel like it's an orangey red. Alamasca in Cameo. I still have yet to wear this. I don't know what's wrong with me. I put a Morgan Taylor in the wrong spot, but this is Morgan Taylor in No Filter Needed. Moving on to the second tier, which starts the indies, and this is Atomic Polish in Just One More Chapter. Great Lakes Lacquer in You Can't Knock Me Down. Quixotic Polish in Chartreuse Swizzle. I've been dying to get this one for years and I finally got it. Thank you so much, Amy Sue. Polished for Days in Glacier Skies. Polished for Days in Amelia. Polished for Days in Hitchhiking Ghosts. Polished for Days in Fire Rainbow. Polished for Days in Rockabilly. Peach Tree Polished, and this is in Carrington. Cirque Colors in Acid Wash. Cirque Colors in Narcisse, which was from the Vice Collection, and it still looks amazing. Cirque Colors in this name, whom I can never say. Cirque Colors in Thirsty. Cirque Colors in Cyber. Cirque Colors in Electric Daisy. Cirque Colors in One Night Sand. People of Color in La Playa. Again, it's similar color to Splash, but not exactly the same. People of Color in Drinks on Me. Glam Polish in Greetings from Key West. I did receive this in PR. Glam Polish in You Don't Have to Shovel Sunshine. Glam Polish in If Life Gives You Limes, Make Margarita. Glam Polish in Island Time. Catalacquer in Summer Rain. Sassy Cats Lacquer in Guardians. KB Shimmer, and this is Happy Camper. Again, very similar to Dior Splash, but not exactly the same. I also wanted to compare Happy Camper to La Playa, and they're still not similar. KB Shimmer in He Slimed Me. KB Shimmer in Superior Sunset. Penelope Luz in Rose Garden. MJ Lacquer in What's a Crelly, and I do believe I received this in PR. Night Owl Lacquer in Just a Girl. Night Owl Lacquer in The Polished Mage. Night Owl Lacquer, There's a Little Witch in All of Us. Night Owl Lacquer in The Final Rose. Night Owl Lacquer in Hydra? Nadra. Is that an H or an N? I'm gonna go with Nadra. Polish in Fiji. Polish in Isabel. Polish in Arity. Polish in Toxic Jungle. Polish in Sleeping at the Cama. I actually have worn this before. This is a repurchase. It was actually repurchased for a friend and she decided to leave it in my house, so I'm just putting it on the rack. Cuticula again. In Samantha? I wanted to wear this for the spring, but I didn't do it, so I wanted to have this on here. Ethereal Lacquer in this Asphodel? I'm saying it wrong. But it's a nice neutral sparkly polish that I feel like I'm gonna need after all the neon. Ethereal in Diva. Ethereal in Styx. Ethereal in Monica. Ethereal in Amphorite. I can't say that right. Ethereal in Blue Raspberry. Ethereal in the Shell Phone Oops. Ethereal in Reptilian. Ethereal in Sidra. Bee's Knees Lacquer, oops. Bee's Knees Lacquer in All Jusk and No Gregor, and this one was sent for PR. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Iron, and this one I did purchase. Bee's Knees Lacquer, The Blood Rite, another one I did purchase. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Pistachio BSC, I did purchase this one as well. Bee's Knees Lacquer in We'll Carve Our Own Path, another one I purchased. Bee's Knees Lacquer in The Law of Surprise, and this one I purchased as well, I think. I may have gotten this in PR, but I think I purchased this. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Double Trouble, I purchased this one. Bee's Knees Lacquer in I Punched the Initiative, I definitely purchased this one. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Bulgasari, I think that I received this in PR. Starting off with the Wildflower Lacquer, I have Verdant. I did purchase all of these, actually. Most of these. Wildflower Lacquer in Sun Chaser. Wildflower Lacquer in Buenos Accidentes. Wildflower Lacquer in Shake That Laffy Taffy. Wildflower Lacquer in I Want to Break Free. Wildflower Lacquer in Slug Bug. Wildflower Lacquer in Later Gator. Wildflower Lacquer in Painting the Roses Red. Wildflower Lacquer in Reverie. Wildflower Lacquer in I'm Basically 29. Wildflower Lacquer in Lord of the Mountain. And just to show you that I'm Basically 29 and Lord of the Mountain are not as similar as you may have thought. Wildflower Lacquer in Tequila Sunrise. Whoa. Wildflower Lacquer in Bauble. Next we have Wildflower Lacquer in Eloquence. Wildflower Lacquer in Panic at the Discus. Wildflower Lacquer in You Had Me at Hydrangea. Wildflower Lacquer in Don't Be Jelly. And obviously I got some acetone on that. Such a bummer. Wildflower Lacquer in Intelligence. Wildflower Lacquer in Sunbeams. And this is more of a transitioning to fall polish for me, but it looks so pretty. Wildflower Lacquer in Angel or Aurora, Angel Aura Quartz. I can't say it. Wildflower Lacquer in Taste the Rainbow. Wildflower Lacquer in Pour Some Sugar on Me. Wildflower Lacquer in You're Simply the Best. Wildflower Lacquer in Smarty Pants. And Wildflower Lacquer in You're a Lifesaver. Fancy Gloss in Orange Pop. I could have sworn I wore this, but I Fancy Gloss in Caribbean Green. Fancy Gloss in Limonata. Painted Polish in 2019. Cuticula in Dragon Glass. And these are all kind of rollovers. Dragon Glass is a rollover from the fall or winter rack, I believe. Moonshine Manny in Dream Baby. I do have the original OPI Teenage Dream. Paradox Polish in Sea Bastards. Paradox Polish in Avogadro's number. I cannot wait to wear this one. Glisten and Glow in Minty Fresh. Nailed It in Limber Up. Nailed It in Butterfly Kisses. Nailed It in Lush. Blush Lacquer in Bungalow Breeze. I did receive Bungalow Breeze in PR. Blush Lacquer in Cabana Boy. I also received this one in PR. Blush Lacquers in Moss Covered Cottage. I did purchase this one. Blush Lacquers in Heatwave in Havana. Garden Path Lacquer, which used to be Lollipop Posse Lacquer. And this is Demon to Some. Another Garden Path Lacquer in New Age Philosophy Major. This is Colores de Carol, and this is Maple Syrup Marmalade. Bluebird Lacquer in Front and Centaur. Bluebird in Tulminating. And Zombie Claw in Snow Leopard Cuddles. All right, so that is it. Those are all the polishes that I have on my rack for summer of 2022. Actually, don't have a full, like, every tier has polishes in it, but they're not bursting at the seams, surprisingly. I actually wear a lot of my summer polishes. And I don't buy that many summer polishes. It's not generally my favorite season to buy polishes, except when I got into neons in 2019. I have some oldies but goodies that I'll try to bring in, sort of like the splash that I have on now. I wear that every year. There are some polishes that I wear every season, and that's why I don't have that many for the summer rack, but I still like the amounts that I have. It looks really good, and I'm happy with my selection. Thank you everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video, for requesting this video, because I really was not sure that anybody would be interested in seeing my entire rack since it's such a long video. But I appreciate you letting me know in my previous one that you wanted to see it. If you want to see the previous one, just in case you haven't seen it, I'll put the link up above, or you can check it out in my channel or playlist. And again, thanks everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this. Don't forget to watch all of the other collaborators for this summer polish rack collaboration if you haven't seen them before. Thanks to Amanda for taking the time to organize this, and I'll see everyone in my next video. Bye!